Kinematics, the study of motion of objects by not considering the cause. The cause for the motion is force. So we don't consider the force in our discussion. Still we talk about the motion of the object, and that discussion comes under kinematics. And in this kinematics, I am going to use two words very regularly. Those two words are rest and motion. When do we say that the object is at rest, and when do we say that the object is in motion? Let me take one example. The duster on the table is at rest. Let me take one example. The duster on the table and the student who is moving away from me. What is the answer by me about the position of that duster and the student who is moving away from me? I answer that the duster is at rest and the student is in motion. How can I answer? Even though we don't know the knowledge of physics, anyone answer the same. How? That means the distance of the duster from me is not changing with time. That's why I answer that the duster is at rest. And the distance of the student from me is changing with time. That's why I answer that the student is in motion. And let me take one example so that we can understand what do you mean by rest and motion, and how can we answer that the body is at rest and the body is in motion. This is bus. Here is the driver. Here is the passenger. And the bus is moving in particular direction. Let me say it moves 100 meters in time t seconds. And one more person I am considering, who is at rest on the ground. Now I am talking about driver. This passenger answered that the driver is at rest because his distance from the passenger is not changing with the time. So the passenger answered that the driver is at rest. About the same driver, the person on the ground answered that the driver is in motion because the distance of this driver from the person on the ground is changing with time. That's why this person answered that the driver is in motion. But as far as physics is concerned, technically, how we take this situation, we will assume a coordinate system. We call this as a reference frame, and the person who is giving answer we assume at origin of the coordinate system. Then we take the position vector of the driver. If the position of this driver with time does not change with respect to this coordinate system or with respect to this reference frame, then this passenger answers that the driver is at rest. In the same way, we take the coordinate system one more coordinate system with the person on the ground, and we assume that this person is at origin of this coordinate system, and you take the position vector of this driver from this reference frame, coordinate system or reference frame same, with the time we will take. So here the position vector, final position vector. So position of this driver is changing with the time with respect to this person or with respect to this reference frame. That's why this person answers that the driver is in motion. Now you may ask me that this passenger answers that the driver is in rest position, the person on the ground answers that the driver is in motion. So which answer is correct? I can't tell directly rest, the driver is in rest or motion. What I can answer that the driver is in rest with respect to this person is correct. The driver is in motion with respect to this person is correct. Or the driver is at rest with respect to this reference frame is, passenger reference frame is correct. The driver is in motion with respect to the reference frame attached to the person on the ground is also correct. That means whenever you define the term rest or motion, you must have to mention that with respect to which reference frame you are answering, with respect to which reference frame you are defining the words rest and motion. So by not mentioning the reference frame from which we are dealing the situation, then we can't define these words rest and motion. That's why this rest and motion terms are valid only when we mention the reference frame from which we are going to define rest and motion. That's why we call this rest and motion are relative terms. We call this rest and motion are relative terms.